Thank you for your coming to my session. This session, hacking the third smartphone OS and some mobile device in COSCUP. Today, this is today my agenda. The third smartphone OS hacking, next processor, app devices and Intel devices, OS hacking, and recently Intel device and my recently my hacking. I am belong to Hokkaido Linux user group in Japan. Yesterday, I upload and tweet this presentation material. Please see Twitter COSCUP target. And I printed 10 paper down. If you want to get it, please come to pick up later, this presentation later. This is my self introductions. My pen name is Kappa. This is my Twitter account. And this is my website. Slideshare, presentation material, and Facebook. And I have over 160 Windows tablet and 80 Android smartphone and tablet. I am testing a lot of devices now. This is recently my activities, hacking self issues on Xperia X, hacking new report on Nexus 5 and Nexus 7, and hacking Windows tablet and some Linux and NetBSD, OpenBSD, FreeBSD, and this is post-market OS in Nexus 5 and the other smartphone. And my activity about Linux on Windows tablet in Japanese Amazon, and my activity on some other conference. Recently, smartphone and tablet are very inexpensive in Japan because Windows 10 creators update is not supported device driver now. So it's selling junk well now. This type is US$15. This auto junk tablet is US$9. And I suggest to use tablet and smartphone. This is AI devices. This is IoT device. This is Inquiet device. Car navigation and install and upgrade Android in some devices. Windows game and desktop or server systems. This is install OS and devices list. This is devices. This is install operating system. Device iPhone can be modified to version faster to post. Android, Windows tablet, Raspberry Pi can easy to install Linux. And Kobo input reader, all the tabs, and Nintendo Switch can install some Linux distribution only. Operating system is tested in the device and end devices. And the third smartphone OS, Android, and image OS, same issues, but mobile, the others. But end devices need all bootloader and device driver have some problems now. This is new standard junk devices in Japan. This is the prices, and this is devices. As a competition, Raspberry Pi, single port, Raspberry Pi 0, Raspberry Pi 2, and Tinkerbell, and Windows tablet can hacking now. And Galaxy, old Galaxy, is very inexpensive. and Nexus 5, Nexus 7, and Xperia series. This is a very expensive one, old version. And thick client, even cleaner like Kobo and Kindle Paperwhite, game console, Dreamcast, and Xbox, GameCube, and Nintendo Switch, and router, open world Linux distribution. I tested. Next, the third smartphone is hacking. Attention please. Today, detailed OEM install process are my slide shared all the PDF in this one, in this one, this one. I'm sorry, please, old one, give it. This session is introduction OS hacking method only. This one is Windows tablet. This one is NetBSD. This one is Nexus 5 on the report. This one is Xperia X on Sandwich. And this one is Postmatic OS and the others. I want to use some old smartphone and tablet. Because the old devices are very, very inexpensive. And but our mobile devices are difficult to install Linux. You know, bootloader problem and device driver problem. But Windows tablet are easy to install Linux, like the mobile PC, personal computer. Nexus 5 is more inexpensive and attractive devices supported mainline Linux kernel. Let's hacking it. Today I speak long spec PC only. Linux and BSD are good at low cost PC because high cost PC need a perfect spec. I want to say supercomputer, workstation, and Macintosh desktop. That low spec PC is good, one is better only, like Raspberry Pi. So I think it. And recently, inexpensive device, all the first generation Galaxy S2, S3 is very, very inexpensive in Japan. And all the experience is very, very expensive. Galaxy Tab 2. Old Galaxy and Xperia are very hackable devices because they were sold a lot of around the world. The smartphone OS have a lot of underground OS, you know. But I think, so they are dangerous, GPL license and other, and very, very interesting, I think. And next, the custom ROM limitations. You know, the Android-based custom is out of recommended version 4.4.4 or 7.1.2. I recommended this version. They are faster than the other Android versions. The smartphone devices model setting in the world, like Galaxy, have much more information and ROMs in the world. I recommended it on this world saving devices. But recent model, like new smartphone and tablet, are difficult to hack, I think. This OS is Lineage OS. Lineage OS is an out of devices, Android customized ROM. The recent devices supported Motorola and Google devices only, I think. But other supported the Xiaomi devices in this model, Xiaomi. But support devices are much less than the ago, 5 years ago, 4 years ago. And the old device drivers are dead, I think. Next, the generation of Android changing to Linux application. Today, using Linux and Debian Node, Android changing to Linux application. But this Linux, Android 8.0, can't operate the build evolution. that PRoot is a non-root change root Linux user space application. Before Android 7.1.2 can operate Debian root and this kind of topics. But other Android 8.0 are non-supported now. After Android 8.0 and 9.0 can use user and application now. The third smartphone is the Android OS are much more heavy environment now, 8.0 to 9.0 Android, but have not supported now. All devices have not been using now. I think the users would like to use third smartphone OS, I think. Let's install PX and BSD smartphone and tablet. This one, hacking in expensive Nexus 5, this one, Nexus 5, is US$30 now. Nexus 5 is operating some Linux distribution, say Visuals, Report, Post-Market OS, and the other can play Nexus 5. And one point, Nexus 5 Linux, Linux main kernel have been supported by Post-Market OS. This is Linux mainline kernel patch on Nexus 5. I search Hammerhead. A few Android devices support mainline kernel. Xperia is no. Galaxy is no. Only Nexus 5. So you want to install like Debian and Ubuntu and the other distribution can install Nexus 5. And post-market OS developer making this kind of patch. And next, hacking safe issues. Same question with European open source Linux distribution in smartphone. Same issue works, supported Xperia X, Xperia X2, and Jelly PDA. This one is kind of is based Android only. Supported Android application like BlackBerry, Android application. Play supported EU version, sync-free version, Xperia only. Next, this one is an unofficial Selfish OS model. Selfish OS is an unofficial supported community build. This one, and this one, this one. Nexus 5, Xperia is compact, and Windows tablet, and the Xperia Z3 compact tablet, and Motorola device. Next, this is UReport. UReport is a smartphone and tablet OS based on Ubuntu 16.04. UReport has official installer, easy to use it. But recently not support virtual bootloader, erase Android, supported Android application and Excel application. This is UReport installer officially released software. UReport supported device. Supported device is one. Easy to get one is Nexus 4, Nexus 5, Nexus 7. Is easy to get. Let's install UReport only. This is UReport can some application now. UReport based on Ubuntu can use apt command and terminal-based application like Emacs on smartphone and Excel application and Unbox Android application. But Android application are unstable now. What is next? What is post-market OS? Do you know post-market OS? Post-market OS is smartphone and tablet OS to use Linux distribution. Post-market OS based Alpine Linux operated Android over 130 devices now. Windows Manager supported Plasma Mobile except for the others in smartphone. This one is supported for post-market OS devices list. This one is about Kindle Fire, Google Nexus, Samsung Old Galaxy, Xiaomi device, HTC device, Asus device, Motorola Moto device, Nokia Old device, and Old Xperia, Raspberry Pi, Huawei, changing into devices. Recently supported out of device of the post-market OS. You know, Android File Saver, Windows, Windows Tablet, and Jelly PDA, and this one, Android Fire HDX in 2013, and Nokia old devices, Xiaomi devices, and Nokia, and this one, the Windows Phone device, not Android, supported. And post-market based system is Alpha Linux. It is an Android kernel or mainline kernel. This straight override flash image on Android and SD card, it is a driver system and zip files on multiple controller and the other Android recovery system installed, four type. Install script is only PM bootstrap by in Linux distribution. And user interface, this one, cloud mobile, this one, Weston, this one, X4, and this one, Mate. Auto Windows Manager can use it in smartphone and tablet now. Another distribution, Maemo Lisa is developing old Nokia smartphone, Maemo, based on Debian, supporting Nokia N900 and the other, generic Intel device Orbina and Orbina tablet. It's all user interface. And next one is Proton Mobile. This is Linux distribution and Windows Manager type. Proton Mobile based on Ubuntu device distribution and Debian and HX and Intel Ubuntu operating system. Proton Mobile support post-market OS, like Windows Manager, Proton Mobile reporting Nexus 5 and Intel device system. And this user interface, touch and screen, and from in Linux-based distribution, in this one. Next, do you know Firefox OS? Firefox, now, this one, Kai OS, but it is not open source ROM. The other one, browser ship based, this one, like this user interface Firefox operating system. But Firefox OS is not dead. Jolly OS is a Kai OS based custom ROM in Nokia, and this one, banana smartphone, you know. Kai OS is the third position of mobile OS market share now. This is Android, this is iOS, this is Kai OS. Firefox OS not dead now. But Tizen, do you know Tizen? Samsung Tizen. Tizen closed smartphone OS. Only smartwatch and web TV. Tizen 5.5 released May. But in Tizen website, only source code. Do you want Tizen? To use Tizen, testing Raspberry Pi 3 and Android source code only. Download your PC and source code build and install needed now. It is difficult, I think. Next, hacking processor and devices. This is a operating system and this is a CPU and hacking application and controller like jailbreak and UEFI virus and hacking application loaded SD card build here. Intel devices are easy to install loaded and USB devices. But lock chip, my old one, is SD card boot. Orbina can SD card boot. Emlogic can SD card boot. MediaTek CPU is only low image with SD card. And AutoTegra can SD card. Like Nintendo Switch. I think the other CPU needed to test it. This one, old a Chinese tablet. In all the expensive Chinese tablet using the Arduino CPU, Arduino processor can boot Linux from SD card. This one. This is all the, you know, 7-inch tablet. In 2014, supported now. All the tablet can install post-market OS and the other distribution. So some tablet easy to buy it. Let's test Arduino tablet. And this is lock chip, Android stick PC and tablet. Can install Ubuntu in 2014. This one. And next, A-Logic CPU is Ambient distribution. Ambient is Debian-based ARM distribution. Ambient can boot from Linux, from SD card, single board computer, every box, and stick PC in Chinese. Ambient can boot dual boot, Android, and Linux. Ambient supported a lot of ARM chips, and this is supporting chips, Arduino, A-Logic, and Mystery, Marvel, and Logchip, and something. Next, hacking and tablet. This is Debian on Kobo e book reader and Debian on Kindle Paperwhite e book reader and all the Tegra devices and Nexus 7. And next, NetBSD. I test NetBSD now. NetBSD supports a lot of devices like PC, PDA, or smartphone game console, and all the Zaos and Dreamcast, and Nintendo 64, and the other old computer. And next we supported IB202 PDA, old one. Supported like Linux DOS in Japanese, and WC0 in Japanese, ARM devices, MIPS devices, Intel devices, VR devices, Super SH devices, NetBSD OS Drive Image can download it. If you have the old one, let's install NetBSD. And this is a Kobo e-reader, e-book reader, and Debian. The old e-book reader, Kobo, based Linux. The other e-book reader, based Linux. This is only change SD card in Debian. Easy to install Linux, change SD card only. Debian can put JC. This card is 2-volt now. And NetBSD can put it. Next, Windows Phone. Do you know Windows? Do you have Windows Phone? Nokia or the Lumia smartphone can boot Android custom ROM. They can unlock bootloader too, like Android. And also, Lumia 950 XL can boot Windows 10 ARM device. You know, this is a YouTube. Deported it. But Windows RT is not deported now. It is difficult. Next. The old smartphone and iPod Touch. Out of supported Windows iPhone 1, 2, 4, first to 4th. iPod Touch 4G and first iPad can install Android and Linux. This is open iBoot, hacking bootloader, and open Android. Android can install from 2010 to 2040. Unfortunately, it seems that it does not operate completely. Device driver is not detected now. Next, this is Raspberry Pi based on Plasma Mobile. Raspberry Pi can install Plasma Mobile in Raspberry on desktop. They can be testing smartphone user interface in Raspberry Pi and the others. Next, listen to Intel devices. I bought and testing GPD micro PC and GPD devices. There is Gemini Lake based on Atom notebook. This is no GPU driver or black screen with 19.34. But mainline kernel 5.2 is supported to GPU driver. So if you want to use a good can play GPU driver the rotation screen, upgrade mainline kernel. And another devices, GPD pocket first and second, TPD pocket passes is atom device has some out of bounds. And TPD pocket core M like notebook. No atom bounds in Linux is very stable and reliable. I'm testing the synthetic paper and replacing with the BSD. Supported, this one is supported some driver in Linux cloud. And next, free BSD testing. I testing free BSD on TPD pocket. And good FreeBSD now in this one. But FreeBSD GPU driver is generic paper hard drive only. Can do it. And next, NetBSD testing now in Windows tablet. And I testing OpenBSD Windows tablet. Testing OpenBSD in tablet now. And OpenBSD can use touchscreen driver and Wi-Fi driver. And I'm testing some Windows tablet now. This is OpenBSD supported XO and Theater driver. This one, check button and touchscreen OK. The other touchscreen OK. But this one is the touchscreen energy. It is not porting OpenBSD driver, I think. Next, last thing, my scope is auto ultra mobile PC. Last year, in Debian based Intel device can download in Raspberry Pi website. Raspberry Pi desktop can install all the PC devices and use it, like Raspberry Pi. Let's install it, your software, and the other program. The other one is Windows based Ubuntu installer testing, like Ubuntu. For Ubuntu is dual Ubuntu installer, only exe file in Windows. Ubuntu install one file only in bootback merge file. No separated Windows partition, no separate Windows bootloader, and self-install and delete in Windows. In Debian, Q4OS supported Ruby. Based on Debian, inter-device only. Let's install Ubuntu and Debian Q4OS in Windows OS. Next, Android inter-device in the Windows tablet. Android is can play Windows tablet on GPD devices. It supported the kernel 4.19, have some drivers and bug fixing some devices. Like this newer one is auto bug fix, so I can use it in some devices in Android. And the other one, Phoenix OS, do you know? Phoenix OS can install Windows and double click exe file only. And next one, Cloud Ready. Chrome OS on Windows tablet and GPU pocket. Cloud Ready is a free Chrome OS operating system. All PC can use Chrome and Android and Linux application. Thank you for very much. Conclusions. Out of inexpensive device can install Linux the old smartphone tablet. This one, some smartphone OS can install some devices only. Some processor can install boot Linux from SD card, dual boot. And Windows tablet can install Linux and BSD easy. Let's install Linux. Thank you very much. Do you have any more question?
Will you take the Huawei Harmony OS?
I don't see Huawei OS. I don't test it. I'm sorry.
Thanks for your sharing. I just wondering, what would you do after hacking these old devices? What would you do after hacking these old devices?
How to do?
What would you like to do after hacking these devices? Like, play old games or something like that? What's your purpose of hacking old devices?
I'm sorry.
Ah,
second. And I understand AI devices, like classified, and IoT devices, and chiplet devices. And classified has a very good interface, but no screen, and no battery, and no some device. But tablet and smartphone have output sensor and screen battery, and very, very inexpensive, I think. Thank you very much. Supported this device. Easy to get Nexus 4, Nexus 5, Nexus 7, this one. I am using Nexus 5 in the reporter. This is US 30 dollars. Do you have any question? That's all for. Thank you very much.